Hello, viewers, and welcome back. It's time. It's time again for XCOM 2. It's time to hit a supply train. Yeah, let's do it. Operation Frost Slap.
Setting course for the Arctic.
We'll get these supplies eventually, you know. I'm really enjoying this game. I just want to say, again, this is fun. This is super fun. I'm having a great time. This squad has been working out pretty well. I probably don't need two sharpshooters. What else do we... Zulu's available but shaken. We might be able to get rid of Shaken. Let's make her immune to psychic attacks. Oh, we might be able to get there. So, the last one of these turned out to be much easier than I thought it was going to be.
One of our resistance contacts sent word of an advent troop transport they managed to disable in this area, and the aliens have apparently struggled to get it moving. This is our chance to strike. Anything we can recover from that transport will be a boost to our efforts. Move in and secure the surrounding area. Eliminate all hostile contacts with extreme prejudice.
Okay. The last one of these was quite a bit easier than I thought it would be, but we're starting to see, you know, some new enemy types that are potentially pretty scary. We haven't actually had a chance to see what a berserker can do. We've managed to kill them before they get close every time so far, but I can't imagine that that's always going to be the case, especially if we have a situation where we encounter a berserker in a pack with an additional pack active, which is definitely something that happens sometimes.
Alright,
where's their transport? These are map boundaries over here. I actually don't know where they are. Well, I guess let's get to looking. Oh, there's two spaces that have cover there. I should have moved her to the further one. Oh dear.
They spotted us.
What is that?
The aliens may have cleaned up the design, but these monsters are no better than the ones my father dealt with.
I really wasn't expecting that. That's pretty bad. That's pretty bad. Who is this? This is face shooter Jane Kelly. An Archon. Where are my grenadiers at? We're gonna have to double time it here in order to not get a whole bunch of horrible, horrible consequences from our poor play. Also, we lost our concealment in just a really silly way. So yeah, those guys have a lot of health, those Archons. Oh dear, he's got the battle frenzy now. Well, let's start with a pistol shot. That was pretty likely to miss. But I wanted to take my free hit. Okay. That was quite a thing to say. Her aim is remarkably bad. Where's the other grenadier? Did I not? I didn't bring two grenadiers. I thought I did. Weird. Okay. They don't count as mechanical, sadly. Yeah, this is really bad. So these things have some kind of... some kind of buff that they give to everybody, it looks like. This would do 5 to 6 damage. This is pretty unlikely to work, but does 5 to 7. And I don't want to have to expend all of my... all of my grenades right away. We need those for stuff. Okay, well that critical hit was really important. Alright, so Zulu.
I can handle that.
Sprint over to here, and then we'll just combat protocol this thing. Okay, apparently she can't see it from there. That's okay. You can combat protocol this thing. If we can kill the shield bearer, I'm gonna feel a lot more secure.
Adjusting aim.
Really, you can't see him. He's right there. Okay. That's super bad. Yeah, we are gonna lose people for real here. I can't believe the game's trying to tell me that she couldn't see him. That's ridiculous. You know what I should have done is, oh dear. I'm gonna start seeing these things all the time now, just normal enemies. Okay, the shield bearer chose not to attack us. Which is handy. This thing's going to get his gonna get his stun lance on. There's not really a lot we can do about that. Okay, but he did miss.
That was close.
All right, and now we have a turn to figure this out, or at least a turn to try to figure this out. So let me think here. Throw her grenade down there and still be able to fire. Thanks to her cool new trait. I think that that's what we're gonna do. And now she has the flank. That 71% to hit was through full cover, because Jane Kelly is a total monster. Oh, and she's implacable, so she's been granted a move. Yeah, that's interesting. Do I want to move her to a position that has better cover? Do I have access to one? Hold on, we'll think about that. That's not my primary concern right now. Let's for right now, let's do this. This guy has the shredder bullets. So that'll break down the Lancer's armor. And then we should be able to drop him pretty easily. Are you joking? What are you gonna miss everything for? Zulu needs to step back from the edge. Thank you. Did he just say I'm dead when we shot him? It's a little hard to understand these guys. It sure sounded like I'm dead. Sadly, we get no crit on either of these guys. I think it's more important to try to do damage to the Codex. Because I feel pretty confident of when you hit it, it clones. So she can't do anything else with this. She can only move. Yeah, I'm just gonna have her dash back behind full cover. Oh, you still have a turn. Anyone's pretty good. Go for it. Okay. All right. Well, a super bad opening move has coalesced into, honestly, not all that terrible of a position. We've been in a lot worse. Panicked? Okay. I would have preferred a mind control. Oh, man. Okay, this thing. She was able to get five of us because of the way our, oh no, and she's just gonna stand in there and eat it. Oh, that sucks. Alright, well. Where's a... Okay. First problem solved. Come on, crit. Okay. Ah, she can't move far enough. Oh, this isn't the right person anyway. Alright. So we move out of the purple. I'm not going to use his grenade, but I might be willing to use a thrown grenade. Not able to throw this in a way that doesn't destroy the cover, sadly. Okay, but she's still... her panic was removed, but she still used up her action already. Okay, four's not so bad. It would have been nice to get her out of here without her getting wounded at all.
Oh yeah. Seems doable. Locked and loaded.
Okay, I'll go. Affirmative.
Obviously, we gotta fix everybody's weapons real quick. Was that, is that German lock and load? You and me both, buddy.
Reloaded. Affirmative. Covering now.
Okay. Now we start advancing again.
No problem, boss.
That's two packs out of the way. Each of them with a scary newish enemy. We did see the Codex last mission. I don't know what the deal is with those Archons. Also, Shield Bearer with the extra point of armor from the Dark Event. That's kind of annoying.
Okay, I'll go.
People who still have actions left.
If you say so.
Let's get her over here.
On Overwatch. Got it covered. Seems doable.
Yeah, I don't feel bad leaving people in the open when we have no active pods. If this is some old school XCOM 1 strategy, and when I say old school, I mean, you know, the XCOM 1 that came out in like 2012, not like old school. Oh boy, if you move someone to a position that's safe, and then you move the rest of your squad only into positions that that first person moved through, you will know that you cannot possibly be triggering new packs. And so you can afford to just kind of leave yourself in the open. Okay, well, good start. That was an okay start. Good is maybe strong. We did kill one of them. This is maybe a little gutsy. Oh, okay. Well, she's got full cover, she'll be fine. It would be really cool if that guy was dead. Right? Who's our specialist? You have Haywire. Who has a grenade they can throw? How do I see soldier info? I don't know who has the higher hacking skill. Is one of these buttons soldier info? Oh, left shift is the tab in the other direction button. That's nice. Okay, I don't know how to see my soldier info. I'm not going to worry about it too much. So Zulu. Okay, I can Haywire Protocol from here. Then I'm just going to take soft cover. And let's see what we can do. That thing has a lot of armor. Let's try it. Got there. And that thing is totally in a place where we could combat protocol it. Oh, it woke up that pack. I wasn't expecting that. Wow, we really don't have a very good chance of hitting this thing from any position. How does it have full cover against the turret? I'd love to know that. This does not end the turn. Really? Does it get to fire more than once? It does get to fire more than once. That's really pretty powerful. Do I want to use a grenade? No. I made the right call. We went back to the calm music. Hold on, is that pack not actually active unless we shoot at it? Because it doesn't see the turret as being one of ours, I guess. That's very interesting. Oh dear, I seem to have developed the hiccups just a little bit. That's annoying. We're making a whole different set of cover decisions than we would if we were fighting an active pack. Oh, right. You have a move because you're cool. You're good. No, how do I? What's end turn? Okay, it's the end button. Yep, you are still hacked. Is there a way to see how much time I have left on the hacked ability? It doesn't really look like it. Damn it, turret. Minimum damage.
On overwatch. Affirmative. Covering now. Scanning. Slalos. Psychos.
What's over there? Overwatch.
Right, I have no idea how many more packs we're talking about on this map. Wait, are the mutants? Okay, they are responding. For a second there, I thought they weren't going to do anything about the fact that we shot them. Got three. That's annoying. And that breaks a bunch of Overwatches. Well, this is gonna be a good time for the grenades, at least. I'll take a 49% chance. Come on. Alright. So is it gonna use clone now? Okay. It splits its health between it and the clone. And it did that in a way that's actually quite good for us. Yeah, see if you can get it. Oh, two is non-lethal. That thing had three health. We mostly can't see them.
Okay.
I'm a little nervous about running forward. I don't want to activate any packs that are over here, maybe, but... what can you see? The Codex teleports. Well, let's not have it doing any other weird psychic crap. The the clone teleported when we killed it, and now it's over here for some reason, so that's annoying.
I can handle that.
Alright, it teleported when the sniper damaged it, is what I meant to say. I think I might have misspoken. Can I... What would I rather use here? 57 is pretty low. Well, what's everybody else? Actually, where is... Can she get into melee range? She cannot, just barely. Okay, well, Zula needs to move out of the cloud. I'm having a hard time telling if this is out of the cloud or not. She needs to move out of the cloud, but she still needs to be in cover. I know that this space is safe, so this space also is safe. Can I move up top? No. I want a single move to safety so that I can also reload, obviously. This guy doesn't really have a great single move to safety, I don't think. So we have to deal with this. This may just be getting combat protocoled, honestly. I don't want to not kill it. Yeah, alright. I think this space is safe. Okay. And you're not even close to being able to grenade him. I think we're just going to combat protocol it. Let's not take a chance. And then we have one combat protocol left over for the turret. It did say temporarily takes control. I don't see an indication of what that means. Like, number of turns-wise. But... it does say temporarily. Oh, right. He has the auto-loader. That's right. He doesn't have to eat up his actions. Okay, the hack is... it was lasting quite a long time. Okay, we managed to completely get out of that one. Come on. Yeah! This haywire protocol has been bananas. Oh, wow. Even through all the armor. And that weapon shreds. Can the turret see him? Not very well. Maybe it'll destroy his cover. Nope. No cover, no hits. Unfortunate. High Noon, you gotta get closer. We can't get anywhere near him, unfortunately.
Ready to go.
Man, most of us can't even see that guy.
Okay, here. Bitte Feuerschutz.
Oh. Alright. Well, we have our combat protocol ready for this. Just such an occasion. You don't have to kill the turrets if you kill everything else. That makes sense, I guess, because what's the turret? You could just walk away from it. Well, we saw some new things there, and, you know, I made a bad play. I'm not gonna pretend that there was a good reason for me to rush my ranger ahead like I did at the beginning there. Even if I do want to do those double moves, I should do the blue move first and then do the yellow move after instead of doing them in a single click. Could have been really bad. And we've gotten Zulu should heal from her shaken now, so that's good. Most under fire, heavy turret. Thank you, specialists. You're wonderful. We did not manage to mind jack anybody. Brain mine. What's it called? Skull mining? Skull mining. That's probably right.
We're taking Advent apart one mission at a time.
No upgrades or no promotions. Face shooter got gravely wounded. Wow, I would not have predicted that Warden has so many kills. Okay, so 86 alloys, 55 crystals, a couple of cores, lots of supplies. Pretty good. Things are going okay. We're getting there. Not now. Right now we need our supply drop. New course. 440 supplies. That's beautiful, man. Yep, back to Resistance HQ. Alright, let's make some decisions here about how we're spending supplies. What do we have available to us? A scientist and a sharpshooter that we probably don't need. But a scientist, 205 supplies is a lot. Let's have a look at what we're spending in the near future. We're going to need to put an engineer in resistance comms in order to get to that other place, the other the other facility that we must blow up.
At least we don't have to worry about keeping the council happy anymore, even if the smoke's been lurking in the shadows.
You know, I'd totally forgotten about the spokesman. The blue screen protocol. We're not really having that much trouble with the mechanical units. But probably there's going to be tougher mechanical units coming. I'm not terribly concerned about getting a spider suit online. The exosuit could be interesting. And we may as well start the blue screen protocol running, right? Because it doesn't cost us anything. Or maybe something like this. Yeah, let's start something running. The question is what? Something that doesn't eat supplies. What kind of experimental armor could you discover? Let's do the ammo. I'm curious about that. I'm curious what kinds of special ammunition we can find. Plasma Lance is almost done. So what we could do is we could purchase this upgrade. And in fact, I think we will. And then we have... Let's pull you from here. Oh, okay, we're going to have to do this in kind of a roundabout way. So we're going to pull this workshop gremlin. Then we're going to put workshop gremlin in this slot. Okay. I'm going to put Sung Yun in here. And that'll give us the gremlins necessary to, Wow, that second slot gives you a lot of contact capacity. I'll put this gremlin here. Okay, there we go. And we're actually going to have a free engineer in a moment here from the power coil. And they're going to clear out one of these rooms over here, probably. Almost certainly this room. So we still have 515 supplies left, and we're now pretty much set on what we need to... Honestly, we could take over Africa. Oh, dude, this is going to be so good for us. We'll get 5 more power right here. I'm about to have that power coil available. So, what else am I using my supplies for? We're not troop crunched right now. What do we have? We have 13 soldiers available. Half of them going on any particular mission. How long is What's-Her-Face out? 4 days. That's not so bad. Oh, right. We have these things. Guerrilla Tactics School probably has stuff available that we might actually want, huh? Attacks against flanked enemies just deal +3 damage. That's really good. That's really good. We don't have enough PCSs that I think this is worth 150 supplies. This is not something you want to be triggering. This is okay. That could be really good. That could be really good. That seems really just like fantastic. It's a little ambiguously worded. Is that +10 aim all the time and the ability to critically hit when taking overwatch and reaction shots? Or is that +10 aim and the ability to critically hit when taking overwatch and reaction shots? Is the +10 aim only during reaction time? Alright, well, if we have some supplies left over after I figure out what we're doing here. So we're going to want to be able to build the new gun. Right, we're going to have Plasma Lance available to us, like, very soon. Oh, we still don't have psionics yet. We don't have a psionic facility. I'm a little reticent to make a decision, but I kind of have to... Oh, we need intel. Like, really badly, don't we? We have enough intel to make contact with Western Europe. But we don't have enough intel to make contact than over here, which is what we need to do. And this is such a slow way of gaining it. We got a skull mine. What exactly does the skull mining project here do? Maybe we need to do this. Let's do this. Can I? Yeah, let me rearrange these. So when he gets done shielding that power coil, I think we're actually going to pull him over to here. We need that moving quickly. And I think we're going to skip the scientist for now. Let's head to the black market. I can't imagine what they would have that we would pay intel for, but we'll see. Yeah. Yeah, I don't care about any of that much. Advent Trooper corpses at 6. I don't know. We'll hold on to stuff for now. So, alien alloys. Yeah, let's make contact over here first. Then we'll decide on other stuff.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.
All right, the Plasma Lance. I'm excited about new weapons for our poor beleaguered soldiers. Powered armor is probably going to be pretty dope, but let's
I'd assume you make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Let's finish getting upgraded weapons. We need to make it so that our soldiers aren't using the default weaponry anymore. Alright, some Illyrium crystals. Oh, okay, so you can also just build a facility here to make it draw no power. That's actually really cool. Oh man. In the case of a ground assault on the Avenger, I forgot about that thing. But yeah, that could happen, apparently. Let's do this. Oops, I meant to hit carry on. Let's empty. Oops. I want him here. Yeah. All right, let's try to make contact. Alright, so things have turned around for us a little bit. We were in pretty dire straits, and now I feel like we're doing much, much better. A little bit of free power for the Avenger. Without the power bonus from Europe, I would have had to think a little bit about whether I wanted to build a power relay on that coil or not. sorry about that. Spy ring. Intel rewards increased by 25%. That's pretty cool. Do I get to know? I don't get to know what the continent bonus for South America is yet, because I can't actually see it. We have enough contact room now that we could hit New Australia too. We're so starved on intel at the moment. What would it cost to build a tower here? 100 supplies? I'd really love some intel. Is 100 supplies and 40 intel more expensive than 80 intel, I guess is the question. It's hard to know. I don't actually know how much it's going to cost us to build the new weapon. We have to take the cost of that into... Ooh, 300, jeez. I mean, I guess it's a very fancy thing. But still, ouch. Well, our snipers are worth it. They're doing real work. Maybe we are going to be selling some stuff to the black market. I'll think about it. I think this is where we're going to call it for this episode. Slowly taking over the largest land masses on Earth. Come back next time when I desperately try to find a way to make contact with West Africa.